By now, you should already know. In reactive extensions, observables are streams of asynchronous data. On their own, they're nothing more than just another flavor of the observer pattern. The real power behind reactive extensions lies in chainable methods called operators. Operators are used to transform, combine, and manipulate the values that are emitted by observables. They're designed to perform a function on one observable and then return another observable. This allows you to chain multiple operators together. It's important to remember, though, that the original observable will never be modified. Each operator will result in a brand new observable, so the order in which you call them does matter. There are many operators available in UniRx, so it helps to break them down into categories based on the operations that they perform. Creation operators create new observables. The most basic example of this is the create operator, which you might recognize from part 2 of this series. UniRx actually comes with its own special creation operators that create new observables for monobehavior events. Transform operators transform the values emitted by an observable. We've seen this before with the select operator, which allows us to manipulate emitted values via the return value of our own custom lambda or method. Filter operators selectively emit items from a source observable. For instance, the where operator uses a predicate to choose which values to emit and which values to ignore. Combine operators take multiple source observables and combine them to create a single observable. The merge operator is one of the simplest examples, taking two observables and merging their emissions. There's a couple of other categories that I won't mention here, but each category will get its own dedicated video. Now, one thing you should know about reactive extensions is that, typically, each implementation comes with its own set of operators. While there's generally an overlap, many implementations come with their own special operators in addition to the ones that are typically included. Every update, next frame, and throttle frame are among the special operators that are included in UniRx. On top of that, many implementations rename operators to fit naming conventions that are familiar to the language that they're being written for. As I mentioned before, the next couple of videos in this series will each focus on a single operator category. And as we near the end of this series, we're going to learn how to apply our knowledge of operators to a special decision tree. This decision tree will help us decide which operators are appropriate for each situation we come across in our code. If you found this Unity tutorial helpful, please let me know by leaving a like and a comment telling me what you thought. And for more videos just like this one, please subscribe with notifications on. If you'd like to join our growing community of Unity developers, check out the Infallible Code public Discord server. And if you'd like to support the creation of content like this, please consider becoming a patron on the Infallible Code Patreon page.